Hi, I'm Brenda Buglione, and welcome to SnowMotion, where we cover all things skiing, from industry news and interviews to tips and films. This week, we ride up the chairlift with U.S. ski team racer Bella Wright. And tune up for a great season with new ski and fitness tips. Later, we'll look back at an ice climbing adventure from the SnowMotion vault. And Warren Miller takes us to Alaska in their film, Winter Starts Now. Snow season is here, so let's get after it.
We don't just repair injuries, we look within. To harness the body's own power to heal and decipher the delicate balance of tendon, cartilage, and bone. Developing new treatments so you recover faster. The Stedman Clinic and Stedman Philippon Research Institute. The future of orthopedic medicine is here.
Bell, make it gold.
SnowMotion is brought to you by the Stedman Clinic, treating Team USA and the athlete in all of us. And by Gorsuch. U.S. ski team racer Bella Wright overcame injury to compete in her first Olympics. We rode up the chairlift with Bella to talk about her specializing in speed, how free skiing has helped her become a better racer, and her dreams of going to culinary school. Today's chairlift interview is with Bella Wright, U.S. ski team member and speed specialist. How did you get into speed?
Well, I actually skied all four events until about 2 years ago, so I really just have the love and passion for speed, and I think it's so much fun in the airtime, so I've always loved it.
What do you like better, Super G or downhill?
Super G is my personal favorite event. I love that it's still pretty technical, but downhill definitely has this different feeling that no other event has as well.
You grew up in Salt Lake and skied out of Snowbird, which is everyone's dream to ski at Snowbird.
Yeah.
I mean, you must be a big mountain skier, right? I mean, you must have been fearless skiing at Snowbird.
Yeah, Snowbird growing up there, I absolutely loved it because it was a lot of the focus was on skiing in general and racing was kind of second. So I fell in love with skiing powder first and then racing after that.
Do you feel that free skiing helped you become a better ski racer?
I think so. I think it's a really important thing to have in your skiing, and I think it just helps you deal with all different types of terrain and snow conditions, and you can adapt much more as a ski racer.
That's a good tip for a young skier coming up. Do a lot of free skiing.
Yeah, that's one of my number one tips for sure.
What were the benefits of going to Aspen for training?
Yeah, Aspen, what's great about there is you were actually able to train four events, which at Snowbird is a little bit harder. We had early morning Super G, so Aspen was great for the speed training as well as the tech training.
When I see you, you're always smiles. It seems like you're embracing being on the US ski team and really working hard. I mean, this morning you were on a bike at 5:30 in the morning before 6:30 training.
Yeah.
I mean, that's impressive.
Yeah. We have to wake up early, got to get our bodies moving so we're ready for whatever this course throws at us. And today it's a little bumpy, so.
You have some really nice sponsors. Tell us about that relationship.
Yeah, so this is actually my fourth season with Cliff Bar. I actually was a part of Team Cliff for 2 years before I was on the US ski team. I think it's just a tight-knit family I'm so thankful to be a part of, and they're still supporting me while being on the US ski team. So super thankful for that. And I mean, I absolutely love being a part of it. I mean, this is my first year being fully funded, and I couldn't do it without the donors and the people behind the scenes.
What do you like most about being on the US ski team?
I think the biggest difference is just the amount of outlets that we have and the big staff that supports us. It's pretty unbelievable the amount of people behind the scenes that, you know, do day in, day out, work hard to make sure I'm out here enjoying this. It's pretty mind blowing when I think about it like that. So it's a good reminder to always be grateful and, you know, have a big team behind you is a big component.
That's great. And, you know, we're thankful for all the supporters out there that make this all happen.
Absolutely.
Okay, what are your goals this winter?
Definitely just keep focus on the World Cup circuit and keep climbing the ranks and just try and get into that top 10 more and more. I think it's really important for me to realize that my skiing is enough and that, you know, what I do in training is good enough in a race. So carrying that confidence from training over to racing for the World Cup is one of my biggest focuses this year. And I think that, yeah, I think last year I got into a flow and that confidence just keeps going, the momentum keeps going, but I've been away from racing for a while now, so the nerves are coming. But yeah, looking forward to it.
Bella Wright of the United States.
I know our viewers want to know more about you. Okay, you're a vegan, you love animals. You're a cat lover.
Yes.
Me too.
I love all animals, but I'm a big cat lover.
All right, what else?
I want to attend culinary school one day.
Okay.
I love cooking, and I love painting. So anything artistic, creative, that's kind of my escape outside of ski racing. So I'll go into a creative side of world after this, I'm sure. But we'll see when that time comes.
It seems like speed skiers don't go on to NCAAs because, you know, you're now specializing and going fast.
Yeah, and I was pushed towards college a lot when I was younger, but it was never really my dream to ski for college. I respect the people that do, but my dream was to chase the speed dream.
All right, well, we got a speed skier right here, and we're gonna be cheering for you because you just are so passionate. I love it.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Coming up, I'll show you one of my favorite leg routines that will help you prepare for the ski season. And then we'll take a look back at the time I tried ice climbing.
We see athletes as the ones that set goals, goals in the recovery of a life-altering injury, the individuals that redefine the magic of getting back up, those that reframe their own recoveries to not be identified by their disability, but by what they will find next as their new ability to succeed. We are High Fives, the safety net of the outdoor sports community.
We don't just repair injuries, we look within. To harness the body's own power to heal and decipher the delicate balance of tendon, cartilage, and bone. Developing new treatments so you recover faster. The Stedman Clinic and Stedman Philippon Research Institute. The future of orthopedic medicine is here.
For all my latest ski tips and chairlift interviews, subscribe to SnowMotion on YouTube and follow me on Instagram at Brenda Buglione 1 and on Facebook at Brenda Buglione.
Hey, Chris.
How's it going, Brenda?
Having a fun day skiing?
Yeah, you're hanging out here in the steeps, it looks like.
Yeah, I love the steeps. Actually, that's my favorite terrain to ski.
Yeah, you know what? The steeper, the easier. When you think about it, you're on the flats, right? It's really hard to make the skis come around if you don't have anything working in your favor. All of a sudden up here, you have gravity that's gonna help us bring around the skis.
You know what I think helps me the most when I'm skiing the steeps was the pole plant.
Well, of course, the pole plant is one of the most important things because it's gonna keep you square to the slope of the mountain. If we have our hands forward and up and ready to pole plant, that's gonna help all that. Also, the pole plant helps us with that timing. You know, so if you pole plant, you're turning. You pole plant and you're turning. And if you get that pole plant out of sync, all of a sudden you're gonna lose your sync and timing, and that's when you get out of control.
Okay, what's number two?
I would say number two is you wanna lean actually out away from the hill, because then that brings you over the downhill ski, right? And I know it seems like you're leaning away from safety, but you're actually more safe. So if I am here, right, you can't pull me over and gravity can't pull me over. So I'm standing on my downhill ski, everybody's square to the base. Those angles are using the mountain to help you create stability. And also when you release from this and use gravity, it's gonna help the skis come around and create the turn. And then you go right back to the exact stable stance on the other side. It seems strange, but the more aggressive that you get on the steeps, the more control you're gonna have and the better you're gonna do. If you get passive, the mountain's gonna win.
Okay, this is a lesson in life, because that's, you can't always have to play offensively mm-hmm. in everything.
Yes.
You can't just sit back and hope things are gonna work out.
No.
You gotta be in control. Okay, Chris, let's do a little review.
Okay.
Number one.
Pole plant, very important. Hands down the hill, it helps with your timing. Number two.
Number two is face down the hill. Belly button to the base lodge. Keep that weight over the downhill ski.
Belly to the base. Great way to remember that.
It's a simple saying and it works.
Yep, and then number three is also that pressure on your downhill ski, and be confident in that. Remember, look down the hill, look ahead, actually visualize what you're gonna do, and your body will rehearse it, your brain will be ready, and then you'll be more aggressive in those turns and you can overcome that fear. If you see it clearly in your head, it's gonna go and happen that way in your head.
It's true, visualization.
Yes.
Okay, so let's go ski some steeps.
Absolutely.
I love skiing all winter long, but I'm always up for a new adventure. Let's take a look back when I tried ice climbing for the very first time and I was petrified.
As a ski racer, I'd spent most of my life throwing my body down steep, icy pitches. This day, things were going to be quite a bit different, for I was going to move up a vertical wall of ice. Expert guide and ice climber, Brad Johnson, would show me how it was to be done.
So how long have you been doing this?
I was actually raised in a climbing family. I learned from my father. But I've been ice climbing about 20 years.
Oh, okay, so I'm in good hands?
You're in good hands. I'll take care of you. Well, a few more steps and we'll be here. Use this as our little base camp and get our gear out. So the first thing we need to practice is how to use our feet. Think about what you do with the edges of your skis. If you're sidestepping up, for example, you would kick your edges into the slope so that the edge bit in, right? There you go. Now that's all you need to do. You're doing great right there. Now we can use the tool now for a little balance. Excellent. Feel how excellent that was?
Excellent. Where's the mid-lodge to warm our toes?
I was content just playing around on the low angle ice, but Brad would have none of that. He said it was important to experience all the thrills of ice climbing.
Good stick. So, step. Good job. You move your left, put your left hand up in a hole.
I can't believe I made this.
Good job, partner.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
We don't just repair injuries, we look within. To harness the body's own power to heal and decipher the delicate balance of tendon, cartilage, and bone. Developing new treatments so you recover faster. The Stedman Clinic and Stedman Philippon Research Institute. The future of orthopedic medicine is here.
If we want to protect the places we love, we must vote. America is a nation of many nations, many histories, many experiences. But despite our different paths, we all converged here. You see, our common ground is the land itself, our playgrounds, and places we love. Now we must protect them from the effects of climate change. If you love the land, make a plan to vote this November.
Dream job? Oh God. Marine biologist.
A food critic.
I already started a coffee roasting business, Pacific Crest Coffee Company. And our first location is doing really well, and we're opening up a second location now in Truckee. Outside of ski racing, definitely dream job. Heli ski guide.
Lifty at Cochrane Ski Area.
SnowMotion is brought to you by Surefoot. Better fitting, better skiing. And by Vocal, high tech made where we live and ski. Welcome back to SnowMotion. I skied all day long and I'm still feeling strong. The time I put in the gym has definitely paid off. Here's one of my favorite leg routines that will help you get ready for the ski season.
Okay. Say you're going on a big ski vacation and you haven't been able to prepare as much as you'd like to. Will you give us an exercise or a routine that will help us be able to ski multiple days, enjoy powder, and just ski hard?
Absolutely. I call this the Chris Neural Leg Circuit.
Okay.
Right. So it's gonna involve four exercises. You're gonna do squats. So let's go ahead and square your feet up. You're gonna give me 20 bodyweight squats at a nice quick pace with good form. Right, when we do those squats, we go down to approximately 90 degrees, no need to go any lower than that right now. So you're gonna do 20 of those squats, then we're immediately gonna go right into 20 reverse lunges, 10 each leg. So you're gonna start stepping back, you're gonna give me 10 of those each leg, alternating, very good. Right, after that, you're immediately gonna go into 10 step ups each leg. Right, so alternating legs, step all the way up, drive that knee, step down. Good.
So opposite hand, opposite leg though.
You got it, just like you're running. So 10 of those each leg. And then the fourth and final exercise is a jump, right? So feet underneath you, and you're just gonna jump straight up, land soft, and repeat 10 times. Very good. And you're gonna start to feel those quads burn on this one. So you know that it's working lungs, legs, glutes, everything.
Okay. So how many times do you do that circuit?
So usually I'll have people start off with three rounds, resting as needed, right? But then as you get better at it and you're getting better and better shape, you're gonna increase it to four or five rounds with as little rest as possible in between each round, right? So it's 20 squats at a nice quick pace. Then you're gonna go into your reverse lunges. You're gonna do 10 of these each side for a total of 20. After that, you're gonna immediately go into the step-ups. And again, 10 each side for a total of 20. And then the last exercise are those jumps. 10 of those. So you can do that 3, 4, 5 rounds. Your aerobic system is gonna be getting stressed.
Just like you feel when you're skiing a powder run.
Absolutely.
Thanks, Chris.
Warren Miller has been kicking off winter for more than 70 years. In their film, Winter Starts Now, Marcus Kasten and Connery Lundeen heli-ski in the ultimate proving grounds of Alaska. Follow Warren Miller on social at Warren Miller ENT and access their film library and more specialized content by subscribing to Outside Plus.
Whoa. Oh yeah. This'll do. From the second you get in the helicopter and you hear it fire up, everything in your body just starts juicing. You're just like, oh my God, here we go.
In terms of massive, awesome skiable terrain, Alaska is the spot.
Everything in Alaska is huge, and the Chugach Range is certainly no different.
Brothers, built by nations, with no practical
massive. Huge mountains, huge glaciers, lots of ice, lots of snow, lots of good skiing.
Helicopters are magical machines and they bring us cool places.
Everybody is here for the same reason, and it's to ski, but realistically, you're going to have a down day or two. Here at Majestic, everybody's fun. It's laid back. Nobody's taking themselves too seriously.
We set up a cool pallet jump, and next thing you know, the sun comes out, and we're having a grand old time.
Marcus and Connery found some pretty insane lines at Majestic. Some of the landings were suspect, though.
And just when we all thought it was over, Victoria walks down the stairs with these beautifully salted margaritas. We might have had a few more after that, too.
The lodge is amazing. It's super beautiful. And then in 15 minutes, you can be in some of the gnarliest mountains in the world.
You're eating breakfast. Next thing you know, you're on top of your line. In terms of the skiing experience, my favorite part is just finding new terrain out of the helicopter.
You're constantly looking at everything.
Your brain is just turning and burning in all of the good ways. It's deceiving here, you know?
Everything is just way bigger and way steeper than it looks. Connery is a good buddy of mine. We have two totally different skiing styles.
We appreciate the same things in skiing, but he likes to do more tight technical turns.
His turns are a little bit bigger. You know, he just flows like water down this thing. It's really cool to watch.
Alaska by boat is cool, but you're not really allowed to end a day of perfect big mountain lines by burning stuff. At Majestic, they encourage it. Why do AK heli ski days so often end with bonfires? Because they can.
Yeah.
smell hair burning. Why is that?
I'm Johnny Mosley, and I'm claiming it. Winter starts now.
Well, that's all for this episode of Snow Motion. Thanks for watching, and make sure to tune in all winter long for the latest winter sports action. Until then, I'm Brenda Buglione, and we'll see you on the slopes.